FL Studio is known to receive very frequent updates, from bug fixes to user interface updates to even getting new plugins. It's easy to see that the software is constantly evolving, and it's going to be really interesting to see where it's going to end up. Now, ImageLine, the developers of FL Studio, have recently released a beta for the FL Studio version 12.5. And besides fixing some pretty major bugs, they've also added some pretty cool new stuff. What's up guys, my name is Sankas, and in this video I'm going to be listing my 3 favorite new features that are going to be coming in the FL Studio 12.5 release. First one I'll talk about is the type in value feature. This is a seemingly small addition to FL Studio, but can make a very huge difference, as before you would have to really expand automation clips a whole lot to be able to kind of get exact positions for the points that you have in your automation clips, whereas now we can just click the type in value and put the exact value that we want without having to fiddle around with the sizes of the tracks. Now, again, not a huge feature from the surface, but once you start to produce with this feature in the beta, it will make a pretty large difference in your workflow if you do a lot of automation clips in your tracks. At number 2, we have the Vectoral UI updates. So some of these plugins are taking a little bit longer to receive these updates, but once they do add a nice aesthetic to the plugins that we already have. My favorite update in terms of UI is that to the FPC. It is now resizable, and the pads can now be colored and can receive custom icons as well. So the whole new layout definitely looks a lot better, and for somebody who uses FPC a whole lot, this is going to be super useful in creating these little custom FPC banks. At number 1, we have a super useful feature, which is going to be the picker panel. Now, this picker panel gives you access to all your clips, such as pattern clips, automation clips, and audio clips, and it lets you rename them, recolor them, and manage them in a really easily kind of overview kind of browser. So my favorite part about this is actually that we can go to any of these patterns, right click it, and render them into audio clips very easily. So if you're bouncing down a track and you want to bounce down your individual patterns, you can just do so by right clicking it and bouncing it down. Hit start and you're good to go. So those are my 3 things that I'm looking forward to the most. Let me know what you guys are looking forward to the most in the comment section below. And as usual, thank you very much for watching this video. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and the background music as well. That is by my good friend JTux. The name of the track is Oasis. So if you want to go check it out, you can find it on YouTube and on SoundCloud. As usual, hope you guys have an awesome day. Peace.